Hello everyone, this is RatTechShu, and I have another Battleborn character review episode for you, and in this video we are going to be looking at Beatrix. Yes, we are finally down to Beatrix, the very last character in Battleborn. We're going to be going over her skill setup, her lore and backstory, her Helix loadout, and tips and tricks that I have found to use her as effectively as possible on the battlefield. So let's get right into it. Her first ability is called Patient Zero. Beatrix will target herself or an ally and give that individual an increase in attack speed of 25% for 5 seconds, and nearby enemies take a small amount of damage for 3 seconds. And Patient Zero is what I really like about Beatrix. It's my favorite of all of her abilities, and we'll go over that why later in the video. But next up, we have Fulminate. Beatrix will fire a rapid barrage of homing projectiles that deal a small amount of damage to the opponents, but any opponent that they damage will be weakened, dealing 30% reduced damage for 3 seconds. So any enemy that's damaged by Fulminate will deal 30% less damage to you for 3 seconds. Pretty useful there. Her ultimate is called Outbreak. She will plague a target for 8 seconds, dealing them a small amount of damage per second. But the important thing is that Outbreak also wounds them, meaning that they receive less healing of up by 60%. So they receive 60% less healing than they normally would. That is amazingly effective to counter burst healers like Alani. If you target someone with Outbreak and Alani goes to heal them while they're infected by Outbreak, they hardly recover any health. It's really astounding. Her basic R2 weapon is she fires what's known as the Instastix Injector, and she hip fires when you're just pressing R2 by itself, and it has a 14 round magazine before she has to reload. And if you hold L2, she will aim down the sights and zero in and snipe opponents from a distance. Similar to Marky, identical to Marky actually. Hip fires with R2. If you hold L2, she aims down sights. And when she does scope in, she deals 75% more damage each shot. Her passive ability is called Infection. When she hits someone with when she's scoped in or hip firing, she will infect the enemy and wound them for 3 seconds. If they're shot with an R2 ability, if they're shot from the hip, firing from the hip. If they're scoped in, if Beatrix is scoped in and she hits someone, she wounds them for 5 seconds. An infection will deal a small amount of passive damage for 1 second. So it's not so much about the regular damage, it's not so much about the damage, it's about wounding your opponents. That's what Beatrix excels at with her Instastix Injector and her infection passive ability. And that's it for her basic skill setup. Now we're going to move on to her lore and backstory. So her full name is Beatrix Lukavi, and she is first and foremost a scientist. She's always experimenting in the fields of genetic evolution and manipulation. She wants to essentially discover, make discoveries and she's a pioneer essentially. She wants to pioneer new fields of genetic evolution and research, and give creatures and any creature that she comes across, she always considers, could this creature use what she likes to refer to as an evolutionary nudge? Kind of help along its evolution, or maybe find some way to better it or improve upon it. She's always looking to experiment. She is a doctor first and foremost. Now, that being said, she is really batshit insane, and she has a lot of ethical standards that really, I would consider, are very poor. At one point, she was rejected from the Order of the Sustaining Mother due to gross misconduct. And she was not really too pleased upon that. But it looks like she's been around for a very long time, so she is at the very least sustained, just like almost every other, I think every generate is sustained, I think, with maybe the exception of Atticus. I don't think Atticus is sustained, but it looks like she is sustained. She has been around for a while, and believe it or not, there's one piece of information that I found very interesting in her Chimera Obscura section of her backstory and her lore section. It goes over all these different species that she experimented on and that she failed at, like the Alcmenian Ferociraptors, the Terrestrial Scale Wolves. She even has a common Harasbura, which are these cute little animals that are really harmless, and they're kind of like rabbits, I guess, space rabbits in a way. However, there's one at the very, very end of that, and that is called the Tempestian Greyhorn. The Greyhorns were a species native and indigenous to Tempest. They were actually the species that came before the Thrall. In other words, they predate the Thrall. They are the ancestors of the Thrall. The Thrall race was created by Beatrix and her team of scientists and all of the genetic experiments. They gave rise to the entire race of the Thrall, which I find very interesting because it means that the Thrall would not be who they are today, including Atticus, if it weren't for Beatrix and her genetic, her genetic experimentation and her ability to manipulate them along their genetic evolutions and stuff. So I really like this piece of backstory. It really expands on not only her backstory and lets you know just how dedicated she is to her work, and even though she has ethical issues, but it gives me a little bit more respect for the fact that Atticus as a character now, I find him more entertaining because his entire race, the Thrall race, is essentially created by Beatrix to be submissive, to be subservient. In other words, the Thralls were created to serve the degenerate empire. They were created to be a servant class, and the fact that Atticus rose up and broke those bonds of servitude and decided broke the trend and created liberty and freedom for the Thrall race, I find that even more amazing. He went against what he was designed for in order to seek freedom and liberty, so I find that very interesting. The last piece of her lore, the last two pieces of lore that I'm going to go over are her gun. What's on her right arm? Her right arm is technically this giant needle and injector syringe. It's called the Insta-Sticks, and it is apparently got a mind of its own. It's got a Harasbura brain inside of it that she communicates with willingly. It's kind of like what Dr. Otto Octavius from the second Spider-Man movie and those octopus arms that he had were kind of like alive and speaking to him, and they were communicating with him, and they worked with him. They had kind of like a mind of their own, but they were still under his control. It's kind of like that. The syringe, her Insta-Sticks arm is technically alive. It's got a mind of its own, and it communicates and works with Beatrix to, attack enemies. The last piece of lore is rather a fun piece, and it involves Beatrix and talking to Miko about like why she does what she does and that she like replaced her arm. But at one point during the conversation, Miko goes, "Why is the Varimorph sedated?" He's talking about Arendi. Apparently, Beatrix wants to experiment on Arendi because Varimorphs are pretty much like they're capable of controlling their own evolution and evolving as they see fit according to their needs. And Beatrix sees this as a gold mine of opportunities for experimenting, the perfect type of experiment, the perfect target or subject for her type of experimenting. That's what she sees the Varimorph race as. And the fact that Arendi is a Battleborn like her on the ship with Nova, right in her company, she's just like, this is too good of an opportunity to pass up. So she kidnapped Arendi and sedated her. But Arendi wakes up, breaks free before they can begin experimenting, and manages to escape before she's operated on. So I thought that was hilarious. And that's going to do it for the lore and backstory. Now we're going to move over to the Helix section of this video. Alright, so right off the bat, I'm going to go ahead and state it. I like Beatrix's Helix entire loadout. There's a lot of skills here that I think you can go either way with, depending upon what your team composition is and who's on your team. That's really something that I've found to be rather enjoyable about Beatrix, is I can choose a lot of different options on her Helix loadout based on who I am playing with. So first off, level 1, I go with Sedation. Enemies hit by fulminate projectiles will now be silenced. That is excellent. You can just spray left and right with your Insta-Sticks injector when you're firing, and you'll coat an entire front line of enemies, and any enemy that you hit is silenced for 3 seconds. That's excellent. So I like to go with that for level 1. Now level 2, any one of these is optimal depending upon what you're doing. So for instance, if I'm giving Patient Zero to a melee character, I like to go with Host Immunity. I like to make it so that they take reduced damage when they're in the middle of a fray. If not that, I can go with Virulent Volatility, so that once Patient Zero wears off, it explodes, and any enemy that's affected by that will be slowed by 3 seconds. So it allows my melee character to get out of dodge real quick. If I'm giving it to a ranged character, I can just go with Leech Therapy and just make it so that, okay, you're shooting at him from its safe distance, you'll gain 30% lifesteal. So either one of these is good depending upon who you're giving it to, in my opinion. Now, level 3, I go with Physician's Eye. Enhancing Beatrix's optimal optical implant, it's just pretty much when she holds L2 to scope in, If you press down on the left thumbstick, you can zoom in further, so it increased magnification for when she's sniping. I don't go with Bloodshot because Beatrix doesn't... I don't like to get close enough to melee enemies. I don't think Beatrix does well at all up close. I prefer to keep my distance, just like I would with Marquis. So that's just my opinion. I like to go with Physician's Eye for level 3. Now level 4, I like to go with Vitality, Chirality. I like to activate Fulminate, and it'll buff my teammates' movement speed and slow down enemies that are nearby me. She emits this cloud that speeds you herself and your teammates up, and it slows down your opponents. I've done this a couple times to get away from an enemy that, like a Pendles, for instance, who tried to ambush me in the back. I activated this, slowed him down, and he didn't even manage to catch up to me until my teammates came and pretty much killed him off. You know, made it so that I was no longer being harassed by Pendles. So Vitality, Chirality is excellent, and I think it's great for Beatrix and what she needs to do. Now, level 5, either one of these is, once again, I think, dependent upon your team comp. If you have a melee character and you're constantly giving your melee characters patient zero, I would go with immunosuppression. So the enemies that were injected that are affected by injection, they will take increased melee damage. The 15% melee damage amplification for as long as infection lasts, that is excellent. So you just give your teammate patient zero, you know, give your Wrath or your Phoebe or Galileo or Shannon Arcs patient zero, and then just start shooting at whatever enemy they are attacking, and it'll stack up real quickly because your teammates are attacking faster and your opponent's taking extra damage with each hit. So it's a nice little double whammy that you are applying in favor of your teammate. If you're not using melee characters, you can go with Plague Rat. Infection deals damage to all enemies near the affected target. That is excellent, especially if you're just worried about giving teammates, your ranged characters, patient zero. That means you and your teammates can all shoot at targets together, and that every time you hit a target, other enemies around that target will also take damage. I'm not a huge fan of double dose, considering I think Plague Rat is a little bit better, but that's just my opinion. Next, level 6, I like to go with Fast Acting. Reducing Patient Zero's cooldown time, meaning I can use it more often. Long Lasting and Fast Acting, either one of these is excellent in my opinion. I just prefer Fast Acting because I like Patient Zero a little bit better. That's just my personal preference. Now, level 7. I like to go with File Compression and Amplified Ampules. I'm not a huge fan of Anticoagulant because Beatrix isn't about dealing damage with her Insta-Stix Injector. It's not about the dealing damage, and since she's not about dealing high damage, you won't get that much lifesteal. So I don't really consider that a meaningful perk. I like to go with File Compression, meaning I can keep shooting more rounds before I reload, which is excellent. Or Amplified Ampules, meaning I can when I snipe, I do a little bit more damage, and I do more shield penetration, meaning I can weaken enemies just a little bit before they get to the front lines, or I can pick off an enemy that's weak in the very back who's trying to retreat to a healing station or trying to teleport away. I can maybe pick them off a little bit easier. Next, level 8. I like to go with Lingering Side Effects. Patient Zero is very short when you first unlock it. This is excellent because self-medicated, giving it to you and Beatrix, I'm not a huge fan of, so self-medicated, it just doesn't appeal to me personally. I prefer Lingering Side Effects just so that when I give it to a teammate, especially a melee character, they can keep attacking faster and harder and longer. So it's excellent in that respect. Next up, level 9, I go with Infinite Sadness, increasing the damage of Fulminate. I'm assuming this increases the damage of each individual shot of Fulminate. I could be wrong, but I like Infinite Sadness for PvP. Melancholy, I don't really use unless it's story mode, unless I'm killing wave after wave of small enemies. That way, you know, obviously, a bunch of weak little thrall or minion bots, yeah, they'll die instantly, and you'll be able to take advantage of Melancholy. But not really in versus mode. So for versus mode, I go for Infinite Sadness. And lastly, level 10, Toxic Hypoxia is probably my favorite. Enemies that are the main target of Outbreak is marked for death. And if they are killed while Outbreak is still active on them, then all the enemies that are around them are stunned for 3 seconds. This can generate a huge swing in your team's favor. If you don't like that, you can go with Death Pool or Synchrotic Antibiotics, but I prefer Toxic Hypoxia personally. And that's going to do it for my Helix loadout for Beatrix. She's a lot of fun, and now we're going to go back into the gameplay, and I'll go over tips and tricks on how to use her as effectively as possible. So when it comes to gear, I recommend that since you're going to be firing your Insta-Stix injector and reloading a lot, have an item for reload speed. That would definitely be useful. Also, something for reduced cooldown time for her skills. I would definitely recommend that since she uses Patient Zero and Fulminate quite a lot. I think they're very important and pivotal to her character and playstyle. So I definitely recommend something for cooldown time. And if you want to use an item that does an increase in crowd control, that would also be excellent. But I know if you notice right here, I like to kind of hang back in the formation. I like to not really be in the front lines rushing. I like to kind of stay back and I'll snipe. I'll steal a few kills every now and then. But for the most part, I prefer to support my teammates, buff them, and I love buffing melee characters. I think that's where Beatrix really shines, is when she's able to just keep getting assists when you're buffing melee characters. You can tell we've got a Wrath, a Boulder, and a Galilea. And look, this is what happens when I push too far and I get too close. You know, I can get overwhelmed real easily. So giving all the buffs to, giving your Patient Zero and buffing your melee characters is excellent, especially when you go with immunosuppression to increase the melee damage that they take when they're affected by infection. Very excellent combo ability. Like I said, it's one of my more favorite abilities. That's one of the reasons why I like Patient Zero, is because I can just, it helps my teammates win fights. They just win. And that's just one thing I love about this. And I'm loving this game. I'm loving this character more and more in this game. She's actually very different from all the support characters I've played in the past. She feels very new and refreshing, and I enjoyed learning her. She was a little difficult. I first tried to play her just like Marquis and go for high damage snipes, and I don't feel that she's meant for that. I feel that she's meant to kind of harass your opponents, help your teammates out, and give your teammates, you know, the edge they need in a fight. And as you can see right here, I'm being chased around by Shannon Orcs. They want my ass bad. But if you notice, I call out to my team and I'm just like, hey guys, help me out a little bit. And we managed to kill the Shannon Orcs, and I managed to walk away without dying. So very excellent. I like Beatrix is very good depending upon your team composition. If your team is not communicating, you're going to use Beatrix to minimal effect. However, I've been able to use Beatrix very effectively if I'm with friends and if I'm constantly giving Patient Zero to my melee characters, and then I just focus on supporting them and keeping them alive, helping my teammates out. Beatrix is a support character first and foremost, and that's how I try and play her. I don't try and steal kills. I just try and chase after. I'm always trying to keep my teammates in front of me so I can give them Patient Zero, and then I fire at whatever I can, and then I just help my teammates out, and that's really, and I just take whatever kills I can get, and I do try and snipe enemies from a distance when they try and escape. That is an excellent feeling, to try and pick off an enemy that is trying to escape. But right here, you look at this good team fight, and we just managed. Umbra has it in for me in this game. I've taunted her a couple times. She's really pissed off at me because I'm negating pretty much a good chunk of her healing ability. And she just had it in for me, but in reality, she just never stood a chance. And our entire team just decimated that team fight right there. We just destroyed them. So Beatrix is excellent. I like sticking with melee characters. They're my favorite characters to buff. Galilea, Phoebe, Wrath, Atticus, Eldragon, it doesn't matter. If you're a melee character, I'm going to try and pick Beatrix, and I'm going to try and stick with you and support you and keep you alive and help you get kills. That is how I like to play Beatrix, and I've had a lot of fun playing her this way. And that's going to do it for my gameplay in this video. And that's it for my Battleborn character reviews. Beatrix is the last one. And where we go from here, I'll probably do another Battleborn video later. I'll keep what I'm doing a secret for now. It'll be a fun video. It'll be nothing serious like this, but this is the me against bots, and I just wanted to show you that, you know, when I played against bots as Beatrix, I got a 20, I died once, and then I went on a 28 kill streak after that. I was dying with laughter. I was like, why is a support character doing this? But anyway, that's going to do it for this video. I will see you guys all later.